Then when you hear music like this, you just want to sit down because the music itself is the same.
Yes, I say, what you and you may say, yeah, but it's all transient, not true. If you say, you never move, yeah, I say, back.
I want to thank the church pastor and the pastoral team.
It also for the Asun Pedi for Asi.
For giving us the opportunity to be here today.
So, what day to be Amaya and say, yes, you know, and then.
And today, you all know, it's Home and Family Day. God has prepared a special message for all of us. Because not everyone wakes up and see the daylight. As a matter of fact, we've had a sad news today. You're here today.
And so it just often
said. You gotta count your blessings.
Amen.
Amen. Today the topic which of the sermon is hope for dysfunctional families.
And then as someone become wasam and I did miss you and bet him wasam and in that swa I woke up I was young.
It's actually very difficult to look at the Bible and find any family that is so perfect or so harmonious.
Edine, so you will never find yourself one who say, ah, I was here. That's all good. That was so good.
When you read the Bible sometimes looks like a soap opera.
So, okay, can't yourself now to say a true baby, not yourself, Eka and Sylvia, any idea.
It's very easy to find that the Bible is full of families that are all dysfunctional. Let me give you just a few examples. Yes, at the Garden of Eden when Adam and Eve were planted there.
Adam Hawa
my Bible tells them that God said they were perfect.
But when sin entered, at the
garden, there are two children. There were sibling rivalry.
And we are four.
The two children.
And we are four.
One of them killed the other. And that is the first murder recorded in history.
And
these are children of our perfect parents.
And as you know, and man,
what about Noah? Through Noah, the world saved.
And I know so, and I would keep you as in one.
But we know that when Noah, after the flood, he used to plant all these vineyards.
Now and true baby, I would give you do.
And out of the vineyard, he used to make alcohol.
What? And true no to be a answer.
So Noah used to chaka kra.
And do we are Noah?
It's in the Bible.
Or no sign.
And one day he got so drunk.
And that would be on sa boy.
That he was so naked he fell asleep.
And
his children find him naked.
That's
Noah.
Noah.
What about our Lot?
Lot and Sodom.
We know Lot was living in Sodom and Gomorrah.
Lot, okay, Sodom and Gomorrah.
There was so much sin in Sodom and Gomorrah that God wanted to destroy this whole city.
But
God had grace. He spared Noah, that Lot.
Oh ye Lot, if he's our saying.
And his children, his daughters, his wife. But we know the story. The wife turned back and she was destroyed. But Noah and his two daughters went to live in a cage.
And did Noah? Sorry, Lot, and the mammy, Ekotna, Abutem.
And do you know what happened?
What did we see?
They wanted to have children.
Ebayamino.
So they gave Lot alcohol or wine.
T.
He got drunk.
Oh boy.
And he slept with the two children. They had children.
Lot.
God had favor for this man.
Let us
stand up and read the Bible verse again, because we want to pay particular attention when God says his words. Shall we all rise up? As a sign of reverence. Exodus chapter 3, 14 and
15.
You read after me. And God said to Moses, I am who I am. And he said, that you shall say to the children of Israel, I am have sent to you. And moreover, God said to Moses, thus you shall say to the children of Israel, the Lord God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, have sent me to you. Now listen to this. This is my name forever. And this is my memorial to all generations.
To all generations.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The last name that God says, I'm a God of what? Jacob.
We're
going to focus on the life of Jacob. And then we will untangle and see God's grace on this man. You know, in our account, we said,
in the Bible, it said, it's better riches. Good name is better than riches.
So, if you don't take care and your family name is so horrible or have bad reputation, you won't even get somebody to come and marry in that family.
And it is why we here.
A good name is better than riches. And the Bible warns us not to keep bad company as well. And it says, a man is known by the company he keeps. So in the Ghanaian or African context, why do we pay particular attention to the names that we give to our children? Names carry significance, value. Sometimes you also use the name for Akutiabo.
Akutiabo
is like insinuations, yeah? Aspersions, yeah? Sometimes people name their kids for that reason.
It will be a good thing, it will be to
the classmate.
I had a classmate.
And his name was Tawanure and Tawanonka.
His name was, just look at it, don't talk about it.
Because in the village where he comes from, his parents, his dad, people were always gossiping about him.
If you say, Ekura, now what you want to do?
Whatever he acts, whatever he wants, people are talking about it. So he decided, if I have a child, I'll call him for anywhere and
for one uncle. Just look at it, don't talk about it.
And anytime he sees his parents is working with a child, for anywhere, call him.
He's
calling his child. But he was using that as a means of telling them to shut up.
So in school,
we used to call him for anywhere. And
in school, we not any friend.
He's my classmate, he's still around. Imagine having this person's name in a passport.
I say, sir, what trade a TBC or basketball from our own ready to a BTN, BFFA.
So names have significant value.
A TV ever was so brave, never in a soapy.
So why did God call himself the God of Jacob?
I didn't. And I'm Yankopo, I feel your friend who said, Jacob, Yankopo.
Have you really thought about it?
Have you know that?
Why did he call himself the God of Jacob?
Sent him. I didn't know a friend who said, Jacob, Yankopo.
He could have called himself the God of Abel.
Now, with my friend who said, Abel, Yankopo.
Because we know Abel gave acceptable sacrifice.
If you say, you say, Jacob, Abel, Echo, Boa, for the ISO, Yankopo.
Or the God of Joseph.
And as a competitor, I said, Joseph Yankopo.
Because we know that Joseph, an impeccable man who refused to sleep with his master's wife, and tried to go to jail for that.
Joseph, to be Ginapinti, said, only you are in the end, not your father, if you are Simon Yankopo.
Or he could have called himself the God of Enoch.
And as a competitor, friend who said, Enoch Yankopo.
Because we know that he walked with God for 300 years.
If you say, Joseph, the other said, Enoch, you Yankopo, Nanti.
He was faithful to God. And this man was actually taken into heaven. But God chose to call himself the God of Jacob.
Do you
know what Jacob
means?
A con man, a thief, a fraudster.
Onipa wobokrono, onipa osisi, ochinchimonsadiade.
So why would God call himself or associate himself with somebody who is a thief, who is a fraudster?
I didn't know Yankopo, it be far obia, sabi, or dada mafo, or yet waka drum, ting etunoso.
This is the mystery of the Savior that we serve.
Really, I'm just a moa, or Yankopo, I assume no.
Let's look at the story of Jacob.
Yeah, Jacob, Abraham.
We know that Jacob had a twin brother.
And his
family, they were sibling rivalry.
Now when we and have what we are time for.
The father preferred. Excuse me. The father Isaac preferred Esau.
Not a jack Isaac Epe. Esau as a
and the mother Rebecca preferred Jacob.
Na ena Rebecca epe Jacob asem.
And we know that one day when Esau came, he was a farmer. One day when he came home, he was so tired, so hungry.
Amen. He said, "That will be a Esau free food by our prayer na ekom dinner."
And he asked his brother for something to eat.
And to return him Jacob asem ka oman bibi eni.
He said, "I'll give you something."
I say, I remember we did.
But you're gonna sell me your best rights.
Then so he said, "What Tom? Who penny never means."
And because he was hungry, he just said, "Okay, what is best right to me? Come on, just have, give me the bowl of soup. Let's
have
nothing you can have it."
This has a common dinner deal. Said, "Ah, the penny never made it. Man, I've for penny."
He did not understand the significance of what he did.
So I mean, they are now here. I'm going to so.
Some of us, Sister White says, are selling our birthright on earth.
You move in, Mammy White can say, your tongue, you mutiny, it was asking.
Sister White, what do you mean? Some of us are working 24/7, killing our bodies, killing our minds, and sacrificing everything instead of focusing on the treasures that our Father has in heaven.
You move a bread, a human seed, so a prophet, you don't need to hear human, and don't hear your feet, you want to.
Are you sacrificing your birthright? Like what Esau did.
Said Esau, eh?
And we know that yes, Esau connived with his mother.
I pray Esau and your mommy, Akukambu.
And the blessing that was Jacob connived with his mother.
Jacob. Jacob, and your mommy, Akukambu.
And instead of the blessings going to Esau, the blessings went to Jacob.
And on Esau,
you know the story.
So with my pastor.
Then because of that, Esau was very angry.
They said Esau,
because His birthright has gone to Jacob.
If you say any penny, you know, I could teach in your
which means that in the Jewish tradition, all the wealth, everything goes to Jacob first.
And
most significantly, as promised to Abraham and Isaac that Jesus Christ was going to come through that line, was going to go through the line of Jacob.
Abraham
you see what he sacrificed for?
What would you want to
he sold his birthright of a bowl of soup.
Eso, eton, the penny, the energy.
Now you saw was very angry.
And
he wanted to kill Jacob. So Jacob ran away.
Joseph, dear, says, Mesopotamia.
To go see his uncle. And while he's on the way to Mesopotamia, he fell asleep, he was so tired.
What died? He said, what bread?
And he had only a stone to use as a pillow. And whilst he was sleeping,
the brother that boy saw him.
He had a vision. And he saw another.
Now you say,
I standing from earth to heaven.
Every soul I see for.
And angels to and fro from that ladder.
That I go for this one for saying.
And now the voice spoke to him.
Now maybe can such a.
Said, I'm gonna make you a great nation.
So maybe you or Mike is here.
Yes, Jacob, I'm gonna make you a great nation.
And Jacob, maybe you or Mike is here.
And Jesus Christ, I'm going to make you a great nation.
Maybe Jesus Christ, maybe you or Mike is
here. Jesus ratifies his death right at that very moment.
And not Jesus, Emma, no, sir, a brand new.
Are you with me, church?
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes.
So Jacob called that place Bethel.
And not Jacob, a friend, a fear, be I also at Bethel.
Which means the house. He realized that yes, he's had an encounter with Jesus. But he was afraid to go back.
So
he decided he was going to carry on to Mesopotamia. Went and lived with his uncle. And he saw the uncle's daughter. Beautiful girl, Rachel.
Rachel.
He said, I'm going to marry you.
And I said, don't worry about it.
The uncle said,
I said, David.
You're going to work 7 years before you get this woman.
Song and sang.
How many years did you work to get your wives?
If you don't say, and I'll be here, what's up here?
Man, your wife, how many years did you work to get your wives? You know, some of you say, oh, I love you 99.75%. I want you to add 1/4 and that will make 100%. That was your chat up line. Is that not true?
You said,
man, how many years did you work to get your wives?
If you don't say, and also be out in your way.
When Jacob went 7 years,
Jacob,
and was time to marry Rachel, as the Mr. Levi said, you gotta wait 7 more years. 40 years for a woman. Guys, that's deep. Is that not deep?
It would.
So when you get your woman and your wives, when you work hard and develop a relationship with your wives,
it is when you are born now. Now we are a matter, and I say we are upon what they are now doing.
You're gonna treat them right.
As I said, we're here.
Are you with me? Do you think Jacob could just easily say anything Ahab to Rachel?
Oh, you say, Osuma, Jacob, Sumi, and San Juan, Rachel,
no. The answer is no.
There be that.
Because he worked really hard.
If you say,
14 good years.
If you say, tonight.
Before he was able to marry Rachel.
And Sana Obenya Rachel Awaren.
My Bible tells me that Jacob was spent 20 years in Mesopotamia.
Me chose him to one answer to me say Jacob as the official do you know Mesopotamia.
And after a while he said, I'm gonna go back to my country.
I feel true, baby, no say Messiah Makomichi.
And I'm going to inherit the promise that God has given me.
Name call number go di adia unyame ashame.
So he left. Took all his children, all the possession, because he was fabulously rich.
And
he was so bitter against his uncle that he did not tell his uncle Laban. So Laban saw that Jacob had left, he followed him.
And until Laban who said, Jacob, and then Abusia appeared on Afri Adino, what do you want?
And he caught him up.
What you know?
So they had their own exchanges.
I pay you which now are you kissing?
But at that place, they made peace.
Nah, a honor. I think you gave no mono. Oh, mass will give by.
And that place is called Mizpah.
And until what to a body say, Mizpah.
Mizpah. Mizpah. That is where our Mizpah comes from.
God
look after us
free.
Until we depart. Laban and Jacob made peace.
Laban and Jacob, how
many of you have been swindled by your family members?
Oh yes,
you spend money back home for somebody to do a project for you and they squander the money.
And I say, what day you may pray? Now this scam will be so you be my now this scam.
Oh yes, you try to help a church member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, and then they actually mistreat you badly. That happened with Jacob and Laban.
Sasami EPAC, Jacob, and then your father, Laban.
And it's happening today in our church.
Now, that's what cost you, and then your employer is suffering.
Within our family cycles.
Yabus, you have also a cost.
But they made peace at Mizpah.
Then so.
Are you making peace with one another? This story is put in the Bible as a lesson for you and I. No matter how badly we are treated by our fellow members, no matter how badly we be treated by our family members, we should be prepared to say Mizpah. Amen.
Amen.
So Jacob made peace.
And to Jacob, as we share.
Then he took his family and they carried on the journey.
And to your father, Bushia, and I'm to a contours.
And when they were getting near to Canaan, where Esau and the other families were,
Abraham won't pay Canaan, who said, Baby, not Esau, so the Bushia, I want.
Sister White tells her that these bad memories started coming back.
Mammy, why didn't want that? She said, Ave, I dream Bonia, Odisha, and the Mofrasi, and not Aviasa, everybody dream.
You see, when you do things the wrong way, they always come back to haunt you.
No, Kai Kai, and empty a dear dancer says, Oh, here, be Bonibia, a true Bribia.
So Jacob sent forth his servant with special gifts to his brother Esau.
And until Jacob is easy, I checked the Esau Kobe, Edeman, and was a Munika in Fangoma, Minipani Esau.
Wonder why Esau did not receive them nicely.
And until Kutruho, Esau, and here in Yumu, and into one Yumu, and Jesu.
Because he was bent on killing his brother. So the message came back.
And until as we have phones, as my phone signed by our
he said, Jacob?
No, say, Jacob.
Your brother is very hungry. He wants to kill you. He's got over 400 men who are fully armed.
What the the asuja for asrafo ahanai eba also.
And he's coming after you. He's coming after you.
Now, what will be the
at that moment, Jacob's faith was tested. When he was afraid of his brother Esau, and second, God has promised him that yes, he was going to make him a big nation. His descendants are going to fill the earth. But now he realized that this promise was not going to be fulfilled. So Jacob was troubled. He sent his family one way. And then he went another way. He crossed the Jabbok River. And him alone. He was praying. He was calling his hands to God.
My
brothers and sisters, there are times when you have to face your Creator. There are times when you have to wrestle with the Father in prayer. There are times when your family members cannot help you deal with your problem. There are times when you have to go on your knees, on bended knees, and raise your voice to the Heavenly Father. Oh yes, Jesus did it. In the Garden of Gethsemane.
Gethsemane is room.
He said, Father.
Yes, you can say,
Father, let this cup pass over me. Nevertheless, not my will. But thy will be done. Jesus at that time was grappling with the big weight that was on his shoulder. No one was
going to
deal that problem for him. He had to deal it by himself. He stretched his hand to his father. My brothers and sisters, you have to deal with the problem by yourself. Is it a relationship problem? Is it a problem with your children? Are you losing control of your children? Is it an immigration problem? Is it a physical health problem? Is it a financial problem? No one can help you with that. It's only you and your God. You have to go on your knees and pray. Oh, yes, the Bible tells me that Jacob was praying. And as he was praying, yes, he saw that someone was wrestling with him. Physically wrestling with him. And Jacob was wrestling with this man, matching strength with strength. Oh, yes, and he realized that, yes, he was not going to let this person go. Because that area was full of armed robbers.
If he said, not only say, I'm going to come for any beer, I've been.
So Jacob didn't want the person to have the upper hand. But we know that at some stage, this visitor touched his tongue. Now that whole moment, Jacob was crippled. My brothers and sisters, there are times when we have to be crippled by our Father. There are times we have to go to the crucibles of fire for God to get our attention. There are times we have to go through difficult financial situations. There are times when we as a family have to endure difficulties. Not because God doesn't love us, but he wants to draw our attention to him. Because he loves us. And the only way he can get our attention is for us to be crippled at times.
Odie dem.
Are you with me, church? Are you with me, church? Jacob was crippled.
Jacob, I did them.
And through prayer,
he
said, I'm not going to let this man go. Because I know that, yes, he is the creator.
If you say, away,
and the visitor said, no, let me go. Daybreak is coming.
And I want to say,
Jacob said, no.
Jacob said, yeah,
you see, when you encounter with the Father, when you have a supernatural encounter with our Savior, you hold him deep. You hold him deep. And you let him go.
Now,
because you know that.
If you say, with him say,
he is your Messiah.
Or
are you with me, church? Are you with me, church?
Amen.
There's power in prayer.
To me, it will end Bible.
There's power in prayer.
To me, it will end Bible.
Yes, the Bible is full of all examples of what power that prayer has got.
And Joseph, dear, that's a pray.
We know that it's true power that the Red Sea was able to be parted when the Israelites were in the wilderness. Oh, Peter and John at the temple gate called, they say they're doing the hour of prayer. It's true power prayer that they're able to do. When that lame man saw Peter and John,
they
were asked for money. He was asking for money.
Now was risky.
But Peter said, gold and silver have I none. But what I have, I'll give it to you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Rise up and walk.
Sorry,
and the Bible tells me at that very moment, healing was restored to this man. What
do
you say to that church? There's healing, there's power in the name of Jesus. There's restoration in the name of Jesus. There's salvation in the name of Jesus. If you agree with me, say amen. What is your problem? What is your trouble? That God cannot deal with it.
It's
a matter of fact, if you look at the children of Jacob, they had so many solid things that they did. Some sleeping with Jacob's concubines. Some sleeping with their sisters. Some selling their brother to Egypt. So many things. Yet, Jacob's children,
heard
the names, 12 names that will be on the gates of heaven. Do you get me, church? God is interested in the sinner, but hates sin. And it's a difficult concept that people find to grasp. God does not condone the bad things that we do. But he doesn't reject us. He loves us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
So then
whosoever believed in him.
Then you begin at you.
He said what? Whosoever. That includes you and me.
Okay, means we come.
There was a young king. Instead of going to war with his people.
He
stood on top of his balcony. And he was watching, looking around. And he saw a beautiful woman who was washing herself. She was having this monthly purification. He designed her. So he asked people to go and search and find out who this woman is. But Oh, it says she's a beautiful woman, but her husband is actually one of the soldiers in the other war front. So this young king asked them to bring this woman to him. He slept with her. He had children. The woman got pregnant. Woman is called Bathsheba.
Bathsheba.
This is King David I'm talking about. And when King David's servant is made a woman pregnant, he said, He asked for his army commander to bring the man, that's Uriah, to come and see him.
When Uriah
came, he said, go wash yourself and go and sleep with your wife. See how far online King David was? The man said, no, I can't do that because I'm an honorable man. All my fellow soldiers are at the forefront, so I cannot go and sleep with my wife. So he tried a plan B. He gave him wine to drink. You know, when you're drunk, you do silly things. Then he asked the man, go and sleep, you're drunk, go and sleep with your wife. The man said, He didn't do it. See, when sin engulfs you, you try one thing, it doesn't work. Then you escalate it. That's what David did. He said, okay, put this man at the forefront of it. Put him up there. And when the enemies are coming, he withdraw and make sure he dies. And that was specific instruction David gave to his commander Joab. And my Bible tells me that did happen. So King David not only was an adulterer,
and unto David,
a liar,
but yet true,
a murderer,
what you to be.
He met somebody's family to gratify his own sexual desires. Yet this man, he turned down when he realized that his reputation has gone and people were really not respecting him, and also he realized the big sin that he has done. He penned down Psalm 51, and I want us to read that prayer for him.
Oh yeah, dear, I feel the neighbor moon, I won't find on your way, and dear Bayam, I feel the one and the battles or portray a young at your number.
Psalms 51,
and young at your number.
Have mercy upon me, O God. According to your righteousness, your loving kindness. According to the multitude of your tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sins. For I acknowledge my transgressions and my sin is always before me.
Your kindness is my guru, my body, and then comes on, and my body, it image.
And the verse that really touched me. It says, create in me a clean heart.
Oh
God, renew a steadfast spirit. Do not cast away from your presence. Do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation.
And
uphold me by your generous spirit. And Then I will teach transgressors your ways.
Na mechre enibonye fuo wakwe.
And sinners shall be converted to you.
Na enibonye fuo ebesi sanwaju ni aba unche.
Amen.
Amen.
What a messy family.
Asembe.
Yet this man had favor with God.
So what about
you
and I? Sometimes
the devil wants to portray the picture that you have to be perfect to come and walk with Christ.
I told you, number one, so you what you say, won't fatter.
But my Bible tells me that it says, come just as you are. Though your sins are
as
scarlet, they shall be washed as white as snow.
I'm going to
end my sermon.
Before
I end my sermon, I'm going to call the Spanish here again.
They're
going to sing to us prayerfully.
Sparrows
to come forward. While they sing to us prayerfully, I'm going to tell you that Jesus is calling you today.
You're
going to come home. God is asking you, are you heavy laden? Come to me. Jesus is greater.
Yeah, awesome.
Than our sins.
Hey.
He's a greater savior than our sins.
Yes, Mr. Chen, what?
Why are sins about grace about even more? In the crucible of fire, a place where the heat of pressure of sin survives, there is also ample grace.
Well, how I would do.
God uses our dysfunctional families to accomplish His purpose. Are you with me, church? Whilst we're waiting for the sounds,
Ebrahim can inspire us for you.
I want you to ponder over the things that we've heard today. Are you struggling with your children? Are you having relationship difficulties? Is your family in a mess? Take
heart,
because God specializes in redeeming moments. What is your burden? What is your burden?
Oh, how? What is what I say?
In the midst of storm, Jesus is my anchor. When the waves of life are raging, Jesus is your answer. Oh, yes. He's telling you peace is still. Whatever problem you're going through at this moment, he's saying peace is still. Jesus loves dysfunctional families.
Jesus Christ, a dog.
I want to appeal to your very nature this very morning, this very afternoon. That it is your wish that Jesus take control of whatever mess you find yourself in.
Me pese me chum safro se ewe se o pese Jesus Christ e baye.
I entreat you to rise up wherever you are. We're
going
to offer a very special prayer. If you want Jesus to deal with the mess that we all find ourselves in,
I
want us to offer a very special prayer. Sister Tina, could you come forward, please? Tina Matimba, could you come forward, please? And this is not Sister Tina, you're going to pray specifically for God to intervene.
Auntie Tina, you're going to pray Edema and Maburini and say, Evadi, Embra, if you feel.
Specifically for families who are going through difficult time. Families like the families that represent Jacob, the family that represent King David.
Sronkupa Kwanzo, Emma Abusia, why is it Jacob Abusia? Abusia, I said David Abusia, but won't pay at the man.
And I ask Mrs. Noy to specifically pray for the youth.
Mammy Noy, ever won't pay Emma and Mabuno.
Because some of our young people are going through difficult times.
If you say Mabuno means to echo or how would we pray?
There are some of the things that the youth are up to that you guys don't know.
Drew Brebia, and some being in Noma Bia, Mabuno in him.
Only God knows. And they need special intervention. Because the world is racing.
If you say, as I say, empty brick up.
The darkness is coming. Shall we pray?
Let us pray. Holy Lord God Almighty, this afternoon, Lord, we are coming before your mercy seat on this holy Sabbath day. We are coming to seek your face. Father, I'm so thankful that you are still sitting on the throne. Father, I'm so thankful because your word is true. Your word is just declared this morning that you are the God Almighty. You have called yourself, I am. So when I am speaks, whatever he says will come to pass. So Father, I just want to thank you that as sinners we can come to the great I am. And he's going to listen to our petitions this afternoon. Father, we are coming as a family before you. We have so many problems that we are facing. Some of them, Father, they've come upon us because we have made the wrong choice. So this afternoon, Father, just pray that you may forgive us for making those wrong choices. But because we have come to you, Father, we want to leave this place with an answer. You say, come unto me, all you who are heavy laden. Take my yoke, it's easy. Because we are carrying heavy, heavy burdens, Father. And we are trying to connect things so that they would work. But we know they won't work if you are not amongst us. So, Father, I'm praying for each and every family within this congregation. Some of the things they are going through, Father, they cannot utter them to anyone. They can only go into their closet and cry unto you. They are crying unto you, God, because you are a victorious God. Your word says, Father, that those who come to you, Father, you are going to help them indeed. The children of Israel, they had no idea about where they were going, but you opened the Red Sea for them, and they walked on dry land. Father, in your word, we hear of instances when the children of Israel, even when they were when they approached Jericho, they didn't know what to do, but Father, you performed a miracle and the walls just fell down just because people followed your instructions. So this afternoon, Father, we are saying, help us. Send your Holy Spirit to help us to follow your instructions, because when we follow them, indeed, Father, all these problems that we are getting, we won't experience them. They are This afternoon, Father, I am praying for the families that are fighting amongst each other, just like what happened between Jacob and Esau. There was a lot of cheating that happened there, and it's happening within our families. Nothing is hidden from you, Lord, but I'm asking you, Father, in your mercies, can you come and solve that cheating? You brought peace between Jacob and Esau. And today, now as Adventists, when we depart, we say Mespa. I'm glad, Father, that today it was interpreted to us what actually that Mespa means. Father, you were supposed to be between us, even though we are separating from each other. Father, I cannot utter all the problems, but you know them, because there's nothing hidden from you. And I'm claiming your promise actually in Isaiah, which says, and it will come to pass that before they call, you will answer. And while we are yet speaking, Father, you have heard our prayer. Thank you, because you are a God answering, who answers our prayers. Thank you, Father. You love us, even though, Father, at times we run away. Thank you for who you are. You are the great I am. Glory and honor I give unto you this afternoon. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And you mean I now she share why you are a true. And I want my hands a woman as a Rady, why my young friend? Yet I was the dream of Frau Yachel and Quack. And then you may have shown my more doom and pencil. You wear your wife, Maraco, and I'm afraid to me do something pencil. See, I share any of Chrome House at Matsia. Nanka is a son come afraid of good in Yachi Basel. Then share your wife to Maraco, I'm afraid in Yachi Basel. Yes, sure, how be pray, I wouldn't come if you ask me. I'm afraid you won't have a farm for one. If I get a wild marapa, and I yet did in the end, Daniano, and a wild marapa, and I'm afraid you fear, dear, walk on my son, Bethy, and a wild marapa, and I'm afraid that you might, and you might make you my way. Ah, sir, what about, sir? Yamme, did you ask that? I'm so good, grass, happy, jump of fame, and I shall answer. Wouldn't the sun be as yet, and no one year wouldn't come. So we have almost the car. Last week here, it be up in Babington Road. But before we see the car, my friend, we. You go ahead, there was a good race. Where you have a thing. Now, so you're I'm a one, you know. And you're back for the year, you know, it's yourself, I'm such a friend. So she wants him. She wants him to be a or burn some of the ashes, some of the friend, but she wants him to burn. She wants him, my young dog. She wants him, Musuma. She wants him. After pool, one of them, not my breed, don't be out of one kind, sir. But when you have a son, could do a baby. For a woman, I'm going to do it, I'm afraid. Send me a pay out one now. Now, I'll rub them one year. I bet you on me, if you know, if you have a son, sir. When we are going to be in our show, sir, you are a junior. Send me a pay out. What do we have, junior? Ah, I have junior wisdom, I shall not. Fashion shall be a junior. Send me a pay out, you have more accent. You are selected by PSC, I don't share a book. For what don't come in, and may I ever be happy? Near some of the beauty on Wednesday, yes, I said. Man, some ya, elder, I, dear me, and some of you, I won't know what I have of right. Now, one who said that should be one of them, you know, one of this one name. Come on, up, well, agree, and you do. It's my peace of Jesus Christ to you. Amen.
Amen. Amen.